Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host, Jason Turner. I'm available for code reviews, contracting, and on-site training. So if you're interested in upping the level of your C++ team, be sure to contact me about on-site training options. Now, in this episode, I want to discuss where to go from here. We didn't get networking in C++ 20 or C++ 23, and well, there's no telling what's going to happen for C++ 26. So what should we do about that? I just wanted to make sure that you're aware that every single video description has links to upcoming events, important information about this particular video, how to buy any of my puzzle books or my best practices book, how to hire me for training, how to become a patron, how to support this channel in general, and of course, you can now become a member of this channel on YouTube if you're interested in that, which gives you a couple of emojis and will make your comments stand out a little bit more. Now, this episode is going to be a little bit different from others. I'm not really planning to show any live code or anything like that. I really just kind of want to prove a point. And that point for today is package managers. In no particular order, because I don't remember what order I opened these tabs in, we have Conan, and we have Hunter. And we have VC package. This is an era in the C++ world where package managers are available. I do recommend that you are using some sort of a package manager with your project. It makes managing dependencies much easier. Now, of course, there is some caveat here in that sometimes you run into problems because the package manager changed something that you weren't expecting and you don't directly control the recipes or the scripts or whatever that are on the remote server that you're using. Sometimes the package manager gets in your way, but 99% of the time it does what you want it to do. I don't think this is specific to C++. I think this kind of thing happens with a lot of different package management libraries for different programming languages. So we have package managers. And as you can see from this tweet that I had up earlier, I asked the C++ community, what is your favorite networking library for C++? Well, I got a disturbing number of C responses. I was really aiming for something that, actually took advantage of C++ to give you a higher level library. And well, we have those to talk about. As I've said before, I'm letting you drive where this channel goes, and one of your most requested episodes was this episode on what to do about networking in C++. And the obvious first thing to consider is that Azio does exist. Now, if you're not familiar with Azio, this is the library that the networking TS for C++ was based on. So if you want something very close to what you would have gotten from the standard library, just use Azio. It is available in both Boost and non-Boost versions, and it is available with Conan, Hunter, and VC package. Now, getting that out of the way, and I'm not going to bother clicking on all of these, right? I'm going to walk through a lot of these things here. We have Qt. Many of you know it as Qt. It is correctly pronounced Qt. And this is a very large tool, right? Qt has everything. And part of everything is networking libraries. So if you're already using a framework like Qt, or by chance WX widgets, then you probably already have a cross-platform, high-level, capable networking library available to you. Now, the next thing that I want to call your attention to is Poco. Poco's been around for a very long time, and that's a little bit more than just networking, but it is networking focused, and it is a well-proven cross-platform networking library. Now, from a kind of quote low-level perspective, we have ACE, and I've never used ACE, but I've seen people talk about it over the last couple of decades, so probably something that you should check out, and that is available in VC package right now. Now, next up is UVW, which is a wrapper around libUV. Now, I'm not familiar with libUV, but I know it is a very popular networking library toolkit for C. And so this is a relatively well-known wrapper around that. Now, I'm not going to go into each of these things. I'm going to focus on the ones that seem to be the most popular. So that is a couple of low-level, if you will, networking libraries for C++. Libcurl wrappers, that's really its own category. Libcurl is hugely popular, and it is available for every programming language pretty much. And we've got a few wrappers for it. So of the libcurl wrappers, I want to focus on CPR, which seems to be a very high-level, easy-to-use wrapper around libcurl, and it is intended to be like a C++ version of the excellent Python request library. And I'll leave this code sample up here real quick for you to look at. It looks like it's a pretty high-level thing if you are doing things with URLs. Okay, so if you're looking for like message passing kinds of things, or remote procedure call, then we've got 0MQ, which has several different options for how to actually interact with it with C++. So there is four different implementations here. Just go and check those out and see if any of them meet your needs if you're doing something like a message passing protocol. And gRPC, now I want to mention specifically this very not well-known library that someone recommended in the Twitter thread called ASIO gRPC. And this sounds very intriguing. It is an executor, networking TS, and standard execution interface to the gRPC completion queue for writing asynchronous gRPC clients and servers using C++ 20 coroutines, boost coroutines, ASIO's stackless coroutines, callbacks, senders, receivers, and more. So if you are looking for a gRPC interface and this kind of coroutine, callback, sender, receiver, asynchronous world appeals to you, I suggest you go check this out. Now, if you are interested in WebSocket HTTP kind of specific things, it looks like this WebSocket PP library is pretty well regarded as well. You can check that out. But then the next thing that I personally want to focus on is REST. There are several different REST libraries. Now, the CPP REST SDK had kind of become a de facto standard. I've seen this used in several different projects. But it has been officially put into maintenance mode and not officially maintained here. Now, I don't know why, given the popularity of this library. It's possible I went looking, but I didn't find anything that of the 1,500 forks of it, one of them is actively maintaining this library. I don't know. But if you're looking for an alternative that is actively maintained, then it looks like Pistache or Pistachio, which has support with VC package and Conan, 2,700 stars on GitHub, would be worth looking at. It says that it is a modern and elegant HTTP and REST framework for C++. So check that out if that seems interesting to you. And then I will just call attention to a couple of these other random things like REST INIO is a REST API that is built entirely as a header-only thing on top of ASIO. So if you're already using ASIO, you need some sort of REST interface, then you could consider REST INIO. All right, so there you have it. That's just a high-level survey of all of the best responses that I got when I asked the internet, what is your favorite C++ library for networking? And now, of course, that is a very big topic. Do you need TCP? Do you need UDP? Do you need DNS? Do you need high level? Do you need libcurl? Do you need WebSockets? Do you want even higher level with like remote procedure calls or message passing interfaces? All of these things are available as C++ libraries, many of them well-regarded, many of them well-maintained still, and available in your package manager. So thanks for watching this episode of C++ Weekly. I hope you learned something new, and be sure to subscribe and like this video.